Hi people, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa and this is a video where I'm going to talk to all those who are not able to study even though that the new UGC NET exam is right around the corner and you have no choice but to study and secure good marks. Still, if you waste your days looking at Facebook, Instagram or surfing some pages of internet, or maybe you keep sitting with the book in your hand and still not able to understand or absorb anything, you keep on telling yourself that you're going to study from tomorrow but that tomorrow never comes, or are you the one who keeps on cribbing and criticizing himself or herself, saying that what if I would have started studying earlier, now I have so less days that I can't do anything and I would again fail in this attempt. If that is you, then don't worry, you are at the perfect place, because in this video I'm going to give you 4 actionable tips using which you can very easily clear this exam. If you have zero motivation to study, if you are still telling yourself that you're being lazy and you can't do anything about it, don't worry. If you follow these 4 steps, I'm guaranteeing you that from tomorrow, or why tomorrow, today itself, just after this video, you will sit down and start studying. So don't worry, take a pen and paper and start this video with all that energy and motivation and have a clarity of your goal. So let's begin. I'm pretty sure you're going to kill me for this, but then the first important thing that you have to do is that take yourself away, or I would rather say forgive yourself for all the prior procrastinations you have done. Procrastination means delaying something, right? So you have to forgive yourself for all the prior procrastination you've dealt so far. You must be wondering, why should I forgive myself? I was thinking of punishing myself for being the person I am. But I'm telling you, I recently read this book, which is pretty amazing, and you must read it if you actually want to understand life. The book is Subtle Art of Not Giving a Fuck by Mark Manson. Don't go on the title, it is pretty amazing book. And in this book, there's a chapter where he states about feedback loop form hell. So what is this feedback loop? Feedback loop says that when you don't do a thing, you're feeling bad about not doing that thing, and then you're feeling more bad about feeling bad. So this is a loop which keeps on going. What happens when we don't forgive ourselves for all the bad things we've done? We keep on criticizing ourselves. We keep on telling ourselves that you're such a bad person. And because we keep on telling ourselves that we are bad, we are never able to do anything good. We keep on telling ourselves that we are bad. That's it. We don't do anything good. So what you need to understand here is that you have to forgive yourself and be more passionate, compassionate about your own self. Tell yourself it's okay if you've not made your prior commitments, or if you've not fulfilled all the promises you've made to yourself, it's still fine. Today, from today itself, I'm going to do what best I can do. Also, at this point, I would like to tell you a very important thing. We all have this habit of judging ourselves based on our actions. Our self-worth is always related to the performance we made. If we did a good thing today, we feel so good about ourselves. If we did a bad thing today, we feel pathetic about ourselves. We feel as if we should not exist. We are such a big burden on the country, on the society. Always make sure that keep both the things separate. In spite of the fact that you've not done something which you should have done, you are a fabulous person. You should love yourself unconditionally. And just look at the wonder this loving yourself unconditionally is going to do in your life. Just imagine a person you are in love with. If you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend, or if you have a spouse, just remember that person and think about that person. You will find that you love that person unconditionally. Okay, whatever he does or she does, you don't judge that person. You love them unconditionally. Even if you're not doing it right now, remember this golden days, the honeymoon period that you had. In that period, you used to love that person for the person he is. That's it. His actions, her actions would not matter. The similar fashion, you have to love yourself. Your actions should not affect your self-worth. You are a beautiful person irrespective of the actions you do. And when you tell yourself this, you feel so good, and then you feel energized to take up the task and do it. So the first point you have to do today is to forgive yourself for all the prior procrastinations you have done. The next important thing that you must do is to break the task into chunks. What we do is that when we have a book to revise, we start with that book. We look at that book and we find, oh my God, this is never going to end. It's so boring. I should do it tomorrow. And you keep it aside. Another important approach that you can take after looking at this book is that I'm going to just revise the first chapter today. Or not even that, if that seems to be a big task for you, go to 2 pages. I'm going to just revise 2 pages for the next 20 minutes. That's it. That 2 pages and I am done with my task. So always break a bigger project into smaller actionable steps. And the beauty of this process is that at least you get started, because you start reading the first 2 pages, you feel like reading more. And also when you complete one task, one specific step of this huge project, you feel so good about yourself. You feel like rewarding yourself. And that motivation, that energy gives you a dose, and that dose helps you to keep on continuing that task. So never look at a big project and tell yourself, I'm going to do it tomorrow. Tell yourself, I'm going to start today. Even if that's 2 pages, that's fine. I'm going to at least start today. And you will be surprised to know that there was a big research that happened which said that 80% of the people who start a task complete it. So the problem is that we don't start a task. If we start a task, 80% chances are there that we are going to continue and finish that task. Look at what a big motivation this is. So today, if there is anything that you would start revising, take up that particular topic, break it into smaller chunks, take one chunk and complete it, and then reward yourself with your favorite snack or your favorite TV show or maybe talking to your friend. Do anything but to reward yourself for doing what it takes to do. So make sure that whenever you have a big project, divide it into actionable steps and then start with the very first step. The third step, which is very much linked to the second step which we just discussed, is the Pomodoro technique. Pomodoro technique is a time management technique which was created by a scientist in late 1980s. And from that particular date, it became a very, very popular time management technique. I love reading self-help books and knowing how to make your life better. And I came across this technique in one of the best books on time management by Stephen Covey. Here he says that Pomodoro technique says that whenever you have a task, divide it into 25 minutes and 5 minutes. So make sure that you divide a task into 2 pieces. You do it for 25 minutes, then you take a 5-minute break. Then you again do it for 25 minutes and you take a 5-minute break. So if you feel like not studying today, not revising, not solving mock papers, tell yourself, I'm going to do it just for the next 25 minutes. 25 minutes seems to be a very simple task. Okay, doing something for 25 minutes is not a big deal for you. So tell yourself, I'm just going to do it for the next 25 minutes. That's it. And I'm telling you that once you start doing it for 25 minutes, you take a 5-minute break after that, you will automatically feel motivated that let me do it for one more time. Let me do it for one more time. And you'll not even imagine how long you will study that day. The problem is that we tell ourselves we are going to study for 4 hours today. That 4 hours never comes. So tell yourself, 25 minutes, that's it. So at least you have a very actionable thing that you can do and complete. And as I said, that 80% people who start a project, they complete it. Because that's called Zeigarnik effect. Zeigarnik effect is a very popular psychological theory which says that we feel so bad when we have anything incomplete in our life. So whenever we have a task which we've left incomplete, we feel very unsatisfied and we feel like completing it. So because of that Zeigarnik effect, you will automatically feel like completing that particular topic. And you will not be able to sleep before you complete that topic. Most of the time what happens is we don't start. So when we don't start, we don't feel motivated to complete it. But if you have done a topic halfway, you will feel like motivated. You'll feel like completing it fully. And that is how Zeigarnik effect can be used in study. and can be used in preparing for an exam. So make sure that you apply Pomodoro technique, get a timer for yourself, set a timer for 25 minutes and start with what you have to do today. Last but not the least, I would advise all of you to please stay away from digital distractions. Now, I know that this sounds to be pretty simple and you might have heard it several times, but I can't end this video without talking about this topic. Because see, if you look at most of the people who wake up today, the first thing they do is to check their phone. And it is the worst habit a person can have, to check their phone the first hour of the day. Make sure from today itself, you give yourself a digital detox time where there is no technology around you, be it phones, be it MacBooks, be it computers, be it gadgets. Keep everything aside and focus on the task. We are so much into multitasking. WhatsApp is open, Facebook is open, Insta is open, then Snapchat is open, Chrome is open, YouTube is open. So many tabs are around us that we sometimes feel this thing called digital overload. So much information is coming inside us that we are not able to make sense out of any of them. So make sure that you distract yourself from technology and then study. If you don't need a phone, don't keep it with yourself. You can do it without a phone, keep it aside. Or put these favorite apps which block all these social media pages. Completely deactivate your Instagram for a while and just try to focus on the task at hand. I would also like to tell you that there's a very simple phenomena which is happening so rapidly across the world that is called information fatigue syndrome. So much information is coming in our brain that our brain is automatically getting fatigued. So when you keep all these social media aside, you feel so relaxed and you can absorb the information which is important. Another very interesting thing that I read a few days back was about digital dementia. Dementia is when you forget things, right? Digital dementia is that you are so much relied on your smartphones that your smartphones are making you stupid. And I've seen that happening with myself. I love driving, and the day I started driving, I've always been using GPS. Even for locations which I know, I most of the time put it on GPS and then I drive. And then I realized the fact that I have actually lost track of so many roads because I've given my brain to that GPS and I don't use my brain to actually remember few landmarks, a few lanes, or few turns. I just keep on driving as per the GPS guides me. The same thing happens with most of us when it comes to remembering phone numbers. I call my best friend almost every day and still I don't remember her phone number. I don't even remember the new phone number that my brother has taken up. Why is that happening? Because we have given ourselves so much to the technology. So make sure that you keep that aside for a while and just focus on a world which is beautiful in itself without technology. So I hope that this stay away from digital distraction made sense to you and you can start implementing it gradually over a period of time. So I think that you can start with a 1 hour digital detox and later on you can increase that to at least a day's digital detox, and I'm pretty sure that you're going to love it. So I've given you 4 actionable steps which you can take in order to make yourself motivated enough to study, and I'm pretty sure this is going to help you if you start applying it in your day-to-day life. With that note, I would like to end this video, but before that, don't forget to follow me on the social media platform because we have some really important NET information which we post on our social media platforms. Also, if you have not yet subscribed to the channel, I think you have a reason to do that right now. So that's it for this video lecture. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.